गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल, आई एम डॉक्टर सुमित अग्रवाल, हेड ऑफ़ द डिपार्टमेंट, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स, जेमटेक ग्रेटर नोएडा। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस टू टॉपिक्स ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट। वन इज़ प्रोसेस ऑफ स्ट्रेटेजिक HRM एंड अनदर वन इज इवोल्यूशन ऑफ HRM। सो वी विल डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक्स वन बाय वन। सो वट इज स्ट्रेटेजिक HRM? वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन द लेक्चर ऑफ स्ट्रेटेजिक HRM। वट इज़ द स्ट्रेटेजिक HRM? तो जस्ट इन ब्रीफ आई विल डिफाइन वॉट इज स्ट्रेटेजिक HRM। तो स्ट्रेटेजिक ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट इज कंसर्न विद द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ HR स्ट्रेटेजीज इंटेंडेड टू डायरेक्ट द एम्प्लॉयज एफर्ट्स टुवर्ड्स द बिजनेस गोल्स। देयरफॉर स्ट्रेटेजिक HRM इज द लिंकिंग ऑफ HRM विद स्ट्रेटेजिक गोल्स एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स इन ऑर्डर टू इम्प्रूव बिजनेस परफॉर्मेंस एंड डेवलप ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल कल्चर दैट फोस्टर इनोवेशन एंड फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी। So just strategic HRM is a coordination or the alignment of human goals with the organizational goals so as to increase the productivity of both the human resource of the organization as well as the organization as a whole. So now in today's topic we will discuss the process of strategic HRM. So in the process of strategic HRM there are 7 steps involved. These steps we will discuss now one by one. So step one is thorough understanding of company objectives. The success of strategic HRM is depend upon the effective linkage between the company goals and objectives. Hence, one must have thorough understanding of company aims, objectives, mission and vision. So strategic HRM basically focus on the company goals and the attainment of those goals. So in order to achieve those goals, one must have a clear understanding of all the company objectives. And that the first step of strategic HRM process, thorough understanding of company objectives. Now the second step in the strategic HRM process is to undertake an analysis of existing HR potential. In this step is to evaluate the performance of organization, existing HR team, to better understand the capabilities and skills present within the organization. So in this step, what company is doing, they are finding out the skills and abilities of the existing HR of an organization so as to understand the capabilities and the skills present in the organization. Now the third step is match the HR function skills to the company strategy. It will help organization decide whether there is a need to recruit additional resources into the HR team to help support to the strategic human resource management process, or existing HR is sufficient. So we have to find it out whether the existing HR is capable enough to do their job, or is there any requirement, future requirement of the human resource in an organization. Now, after this step, the step four is forecast your future HR requirement. Once you have find out the abilities and skills of the existing employees or the existing employees in the organization, now the next step is to find out the future HR requirement. A vital part of strategic human resource management is looking ahead at the business strategies and planning how HR can support and partner with the business to meet its objectives. Now, we have to find out the future HR requirement on the basis of 2 points: supply and demand. Supply is the existing HR persons or the existing HR persons who are already available, and demand is the requirement of extra HR in a future. Now the fifth step in the HR strategic HRM process is to evaluate the HR tools needed by the employee for their roles. Once a company has determined the skill set of current and future employees, the next critical step is to work in a partnership with each business department of the organization. Thus, there is a requirement of HR tools. There are several HR tools. HR tools can be used to provide teams the best opportunities for working effectively and efficiently in an organization. Now the next step or the sixth step in the process of strategic HRM is to define your human resource strategic goals and implement it. It involves to communicate your HR strategies and goals both within the HR team and across the whole business so that it becomes fully integrated into everyday business operations. So basically, you have to coordinate the HR strategies with the strategies of the organization as the whole. Now, the last step is to evaluate the effectiveness of strategic HR practices. After implementation stage of strategic human resource management, one must review the effectiveness of the HR strategies and ensure that it is contributing positively towards the business success. So that is the process of evaluating the effectiveness of strategic HR practices. And that's all with the topic of process of strategic HRM, which consists of 7 steps that we discussed. Now the next topic for today's class is the evolution of HRM. So this topic we will discuss now. So there are the different phases of the evolution of HRM that we discussed one by one. To the first period was the period before the Industrial Revolution. In this period, the societies were primarily an agriculture economy with limited production. Most of the focus of the economy is on agriculture only. Number of specialized craft was limited and was usually carried out within a village or community. Communication channels were limited, and so there was no role of HRM or personal management in the period before Industrial Revolution. Now comes the period of Industrial Revolution, period between 1715 to 1850. Industrial Revolution marked the conversion of economy from agriculture based to industry based. Now the focus of economy changes from the agriculture to the industry. The more GDP is coming from the industrial sector as compared to the agriculture sector. A department was set up to look into worker wages, welfare and other related issues. This lead to the emergence of personal management with a major task as worker wages and salaries, maintenance of workers record, maintenance of worker housing facilities and healthcare. So in the period of industrial revolution, the personal management comes into existence. Now, one of the important part of this period of industrial revolution was the growth of labor union. The workers working in the industries or factories were subjected to long working hours and were very less paid. With growing unrest, workers across the world started protest, and this led to the establishment of labor unions. To deal with the labor issues at one end and the management at the other, personal management department had to be capable of politics and diplomacy. Thus, the industrial relation department emerged. The growth of the labor union and result into the existence of industrial relation department, emergence of industrial relation department. Now, the third period was the period of post-industrial revolution. The term human resource management saw a major evolution after 1850, that is the period after the Industrial Revolution or the period of post-industrial revolution. Various studies were released and many experiments were conducted during this period, which gave HRM altogether a new meaning and the importance. A brief overview of major theories released during this period is presented below that we will discuss now. First theory was given by F.W. Taylor, which is a theory of scientific management in the year 1857 to 1911. This theory led to the evolution of scientific human resource management approach, which includes scientific training of workers, maintaining the wage uniformity, focus on attaining better productivity, etc. So this gives the concept of scientific management. Next was the Hawthorne studies conducted by Alton Mayo and Fields in the period of 1927 to 1940. Observations and findings of Hawthorne experiment shifted the focus of human resource from increasing workers' productivity to increasing workers' efficiency through greater work satisfaction. So scientific management focused on workers' productivity, while Hawthorne experiment focused on worker efficiency through greater workforce satisfaction. So according to this theory, work satisfaction is required to increase the efficiency of the workers, which will automatically increase the productivity of the organization. Douglas McGregor, D. gives the theory, Axiom theory, by in the year 1960, and the Abraham Maslow gives the theory of hierarchy of need in the year 1954. These studies and observations lead to the transition from the administrative and passive personal management approach to a more dynamic human resource approach. So these scientists were responsible for the emergence of human resource approach. As a result of these various principles and studies, human resource management became increasingly line management function linked to the core business operation. So now the human resource management was linked to the core business operation, and it's a major part of business organization, major function of business organization. Some of the major activities of HR department are discussed below. It includes recruitment and selection of human talent or the skilled workforce for an organization. It also involves in motivation of the employees and also focus on employees' benefits and the welfare. It also provides continuous training and development of the workforce. It also related with performance relation related salaries and appraisals of the human being. So that is the work of a human resource manager. Now, we are discussing about the strategic human resource management approach. With increasing the technology and knowledge base of the industries, and as a result of the global competition, human resource management is assuming more critical role in today's world. Its major accomplishment is aligning the individual goals and objectives with the corporate goals and objectives in order to achieve the organizational goals and individual goals in a more effective and efficient manner. Strategic HRM focuses on actions that differentiate the organization from its competitors and aims to make long-term impact on the success of the organization. So now the concept is changed from the human resource management to the strategic human resource management. So that's all with your today's topic. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.